Hare Krishna. To take back the mind, first take back the streets to the mind. To take back a kingdom. Suppose there is a war zone, and in that the opponent has conquered some territory, and then the defending army wants to take back the territory. So one of the time-tested strategies for taking back the territory is to actually cut off the supplies going into that territory, so that reinforcements, food, weapons, more troops cannot come there. And say if a fort has been captured and then the supply to that is cut off, then gradually the army which wants to take back the fort, that can wear out those who are inside, because they will not get any reinforcements, and then they can be won over. So similarly, our mind at present is taken over by the forces of illusion. Although the mind can in principle be both a friend and an enemy, but at present it is largely acting inimically. Why? Because the forces of illusion, lust, anger, greed, envy, pride and illusion, these have taken over the forces, that these have taken over the mind. These are the impressions connected with these are what are prominent in the mind. And that's why if we leave our mind idle, it usually, as it is said, becomes a devil's workshop. It starts cultivating lusty, greedy, angry, envious thoughts like that. So now the solution is to take back the mind. That means once we get spiritual knowledge, once we understand that we are pure souls and we can get pure lasting happiness in devotion to Krishna, then we want to take back the mind. That means that we understand that the mind is the mind is currently caught with the force of illusion, but we want to take back the mind. And we, at one level, we want to fill the mind with Krishna and drive out the forces of illusion, impressions, illusory impressions from there. But that will begin by taking back the streets leading to the mind. That means that now what are the streets leading to the mind? They are the senses. So Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, in 15.9, Shrotram chakshu sparshanam cha rasanam ghranam eva cha adhishthaya manashchayam vishayanupasevate. So he says, Shrotram chakshu sparshanam cha. So he's giving the list of the senses, primarily the five knowledge acquiring senses. Shrotram chakshotra is ear, chakshu is the eyes, sparshanam is the touch, rasanam ghranam eva cha. Rasanam is tasting and ghranam is smelling. So adhishthaya manashchayam, they are centered around the mind. Vishayanupasevate, and then one pursues sense of gratification through these. So the point is, the sensory impressions go within, go into our consciousness, go to the mind through the doorway of the senses. Now whatever impressions are there, they are there. Just like the forces that have captured a fort, they are already there. But if those we will have to fight and overcome. But if constantly more forces are also coming in, then conquering that fort will become very difficult. But if at least the new further for reinforcement is stopped, then overcoming what is there will be a less difficult task. Similarly, if we can prevent our senses from going in wrong directions, that means we minimize the exposure of our senses to sensually tempting stimuli. We can't avoid them, but we can minimize them, and then the forces of illusion will not get reinforcement. And if we take over the roads to the mind, that means we direct the senses towards Krishna. We behold the beautiful form of Krishna with our eyes. We use the tongue for chanting the holy names, the ears for hearing Krishna Katha. And in this way, as we, instead of sending the reinforcement to the forces of illusion, we send reinforcements to the forces of truth. And gradually, the impressions in the mind which are negative, they will get overpowered, and positive impressions will then gradually rule the mind. And once the mind becomes our friend, then our life will become joyful, and we will eventually attain, our life will also become fruitful, because we will attain Krishna. Thank you. Hare Krishna.